that I saw her hair like the branch of a tree. Willow dancing on air before covering me. Under cotton and calicoes, over canopy dapple long ago.
Hello everyone and welcome back. It's actually the same weekend as the end of my last video, but I just have so much to do that thought I'd just start filming again. And I just think that it's actually good to see someone going through a big like life change and big process. You know, even if you aren't moving, but just in the future, you could always be like, that's what they did, or take ideas from other people, because that's what I've been doing. So even though I'm packing up my life and it's kind of irrelevant to a lot of people, but you know, it kind of shows that everyone goes through these big life transitions and changes. And that's why I thought I would document it. And, you know, in the future, if Jamie and I ever go through a big life change again, if we ever move back to Australia, 10 years time or whatever, you know, we can look back at how we'll do things differently or what happened. But yeah, so it's the Monday of the long weekend, and thank God there is a long weekend because I have so much to do still. This weekend was really lovely. Jamie and I had packed away a lot of our clothes, which is great, but we also realized we do not have enough check bags. So yesterday, Jamie and I actually went and bought another one because, you know, coming over here, I just had a backpack and that was it. Life was easy. I was a 26-year-old. Everything was so sweet. Now that I'm turning 29 this year, I've accumulated some things that I definitely want to bring with me to Canada. So yeah, I'll show you that the new bag we got a little bit later on. But today, we're basically, Jamie's at work. We're going to be going through a lot of our cupboards, our drawers, getting, you know, all the stuff out and seeing what we'll be doing with it. If we'll be donating it, if we're keeping it, if we, you know, want to sell it. So we're going to be doing that today. The big thing that we have to do today is that tomorrow there's photographers coming to actually take photos of this place. The owners actually switched real estate, so they actually need the new, like, you know, photos that they show everyone in the beginning. So the crazy thing is that when you're moving and when you are, you know, packing everything out and away, you have to take everything out and then you kind of like leave it there for a few days and you know, like, okay, this pile is here. But today, Jamie and I have to somehow hide all of our things in an organized way because we're taking them out. Because tomorrow we have to have everything clear. We can't have anything like on the floors. We can't have anything on the bench tops. We can't have anything out. We can't have any photos around. So, and we have no storage here. So I don't know what's going to happen, but, I think there's going to be, some trips to the op shop today. Or, you know, maybe to the dump. I don't know. But, me and Dory right now are just enjoying breakfast. I just made some eggs on toast, some coffee, and then we're gonna get the day started. Okay, so I am wearing my slippers and my trackies because it is so cold. But this is our other luggage that we actually bought yesterday. And it's really funny because me and Jamie went into the store and I basically said, like, look, this is probably our fourth piece of luggage that we're actually bringing back. Like, we just want the biggest and cheapest one. And it was one that I was actually looking at. And I was like, oh, Jamie, this looks really, like, big because we just need a big one. And she's like, actually, the one you're looking at is the cheapest one. So for $99, the other ones there were all, like, over $150. So that was really good. And it's super light because we have to carry so many things in this. So, if you open it up, it's actually nice because it has like this section. If anyone was traveling, the section is for like any like damp things that can't dry. So that's cool. But in there, I just have some gifts. So this, we're kind of dedicating this to miscellaneous things that we're bringing with us. And like some souvenirs that we're bringing home for people. And like right now, I'm actually in the middle of buying my mom's Christmas presents now because Australia has so many cheap but good quality things here that Canada doesn't have. So in here, like right now, I have just Jamie's shoes in here because he has so many shoes. But I have these really cute Australiana kind of things that we're bringing back with us. I have like this sheet set that I showed on my last video. And yeah, so this is kind of just like our things that we want to keep in the house. I also have a koala one. And then these are just photos from our area that we live in. So this is Jervis Bay, which is just down the coast from us. And this one is Minamara, which is a town that is also just south of us. So really beautiful print. So we're getting packing that in here. And then this is just like literally all of our important documents and information. And since Jamie is like leaving his home country, it's important that we bring back like, just important documents. Medical histories, tax stuff, that's gonna be in there. But it's actually like, I don't know if you can tell, but it's really, what is that? It's really deep. Like my arm right now is really far in it. So it's really good. So we can just layer on some things and kind of go from there. So yeah, today I'll be trying to fill this. We may be going to Kmart afterwards, which will be good because I can just show a few things that I get from there. But other than that, I have to start on all of these cupboards. I feel like everybody has this cupboard in their house. I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong, but it's just like the most random cupboard. Like we have a wrench. Oh my God, like a scuba mask because never know when you're just gonna go, snorkeling. I have a stocking up here, basketball. Oh, there's the other half of the snorkel. It's just an endless cupboard here. We just don't have enough storage, so every cupboard just becomes everything. This is like our pantry. That's a whole other story that I am dreading to get to, but yes, wish me luck. The last time that I checked in, which is crazy because it was the long weekend, and yeah, last weekend. So we only had 4 days this week, and last night we had an end of financial year. Don't mind my pajamas, by the way, I just woke up. So last night was an end of financial year party with my work. So that was really nice because we got to actually catch up and see each other all before I leave for Canada. And I've really gotten to love some people that I work with. Well, everyone I work with, but I'm really close with a few ones. So it was really lovely to see each other one last time in a nice group setting. But Jamie's dad and his partner actually are coming down to visit us today. They're staying at a hotel nearby. Yeah, so they're coming and we're going to be doing some things with them this weekend. But between then we have to start, getting some things together. We've cleaned up a little bit. Explain. So Jamie and I used to have like a really big kookaburra, like a bird photo and canvas there. We took that down. We took down our Canada decorations. We've gotten rid of our camping mattress that we just kind of stored right there. We actually don't have like any storage at all in this house, to be honest. But yeah, so we got rid of that stuff and we've completely cleared off the table and any of the accessories that we're just not using anymore. We've either donated or got rid of. We're also going through this bookcase probably today, actually. I'm probably gonna put that up on Facebook Marketplace. And yeah, it's just like some bits and bobs, some scratches over there. That's where our shoes are and everything. Ooh. We've gotten rid of so many shoes. I don't know if you can see a shoe rack, but there's barely any shoes on there. We've just gotten rid of lots and decided what we're taking back with us. That's just my jacket and everything from last night that I chucked on there. But yeah, so it's kind of looking a little bit bare at the moment, which is good. Okay, so I'm going through our bookshelf that we have all of our books and our board games on. So out of these three piles, just guess what one we plan to bring to Canada. Definitely this one. So this is all the things we said we wanted to keep. Now, obviously, we have Catan. Don't mind my dirty table. We have Catan, amazing game. Also costs like $70 here. So, I was like, should we bring that back to Canada? Because that is an expensive game. We have Crib. Now, we could keep this here. It's very popular in Canada. But anyway, that is like really light, so we figured that we could just bring that back. So I'm just minding my own business, cleaning out the old bookcase here, and for some reason I had a feeling. I was like, this is weird. I have gone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cubes without spotting something. And for some reason, behind this old Harry Potter chess set, does anyone see anything on inside of the walls at all? Because there is a big ass spider just chilling on the side there. And I'm very happy that I had to my gut feeling.
I saw her hair like the branch of a tree, willow dancing on air before covering me, under cotton and calicoes, over canopy dapple long ago. True that love in withdrawal was the weeping of me, that the sound of the soul must be known by the tree, must be felt for the fight, the cold. Fretted fire, but that was long ago. It's not today. I said a lie. Now blinking so.
Hello. So it's been another long time since I last recorded. And it honestly has to do with how busy we are. And that I just keep forgetting to like document it. And that was the whole purpose of this thing. So it's the morning at the moment. It's about 7:30 in the morning. And it is actually my last day of work. And there's so many birds around. It's such a beautiful day today. It's blue skies and it's been raining for so long, so it's so nice that we have some sun to end the week. So yeah, it's my last day at work today, so I thought I would bring you along on my way to work and how I'll always remember my time at Wollongong. And yeah, so it'll be a fun day. But I just also wanted to say a few things, like a lot of changes that have been happening. So 1 week today, Jamie and I move out of our house, which is crazy. We're still trying to sell so many things at the moment. So we're going to see how that goes. And then, yeah, and then after that, we're off to Jamie's town where he grew up, where his mom lives. And then we're off to Canada in 3 weeks, which is crazy. So yeah, so stay tuned. I'm just going to show you guys my way to work.
With the roar of the fire, my heart rose to its feet. Like the ashes of ash, I saw eyes in the heat. Silver softening as pure as snow. I fell in love with the fire long ago. With each love I could lose, I was never the same. Watching still living roots be consumed by the flame. I was fixed on your hand of gold, laying waste to my love and long ago.
Today has already been so crazy. This morning we had an open house at 9:30, so I woke up super early this morning to actually clean the place. And then we've already sold our kitchen table, and then I have someone picking up our nightstands pretty soon, actually, in the next probably 20 minutes. And then we have someone picking up our lounge, and then in the late afternoon we have someone picking up our washing machine. So it's just been absolutely crazy. Yesterday was my last day at work, and Jamie and I went out for dinner, and it was really nice. We had like a little drink each, but we didn't stay out very long because I had to come home to clean. So it's kind of getting, it is getting super real. I think less than three weeks we arrive in Canada. So priority today is obviously getting everything ready to sell, and then kind of going from there. We have a pretty busy weekend as well, just catching up with some friends for probably the last time. Just doesn't stop. It doesn't stop. So, I'll show you kind of what we're going to be selling. So these are our cute little nightstands that we're selling, and they're picking up pretty soon, and we're just kind of chucking in these lamps as a little gift. We've obviously sold our shoe rack, which is good. Selling the lounge, it's kind of all over the place at the moment. There's also the table that we sold this morning. And then we are going to be selling our washing machine. And yeah, that's getting picked up. Jamie's going to have to unhook the hoses and everything when he gets home from work. But that's getting picked up later this afternoon. And then the last main thing to sell is the bed. But this is actually going to one of the girls I work with. She's going to be buying my bed. So yes, it is getting really crazy. Okay, so a lot has happened since that last clip. And it's just, there's been a lot going on. So let me just do a quick briefing. So tomorrow we actually move out of our house. And it's crazy. So from the last time that I was recording, it was a few days ago now. And that day was all good. We were ready to go out to a friend's birthday party that night. And right as we were kind of collecting our things to meet our friends, Jamie's dad called us and said, turn the news on. And we were like, oh, okay, why? And turns out that our location where we live is actually in lockdown from COVID at the moment. Which is crazy because Australia, as many people know around the world, that Australia hasn't really had much of COVID in the country. But what happened was last week there was a private driver from the airport to the hotel quarantine. And apparently he had the Delta variant of coronavirus, which has obviously spread throughout Sydney at the moment. I think they declared it a lockdown when they hit about 39 cases in 2 days, or maybe 29 cases in 2 days. But that's just what Australia does. Australia declares lockdowns right away. And that's just their way of dealing with COVID. And then they open up soon thereafter. So yeah, that night it was a lockdown at 6 p.m. and we met our friends at 4 at the pub, and basically they all just ordered as many drinks as they could for 2 hours, and then they went home. We went home a little bit earlier because Jamie had to work, but yeah, it's just been absolutely nuts. It has been a big bummer because Jamie and I had so many things planned to do. Before we left Wollongong, we planned to do quite a bit, go to our favorite kind of places, and everything shut down. So we have just been getting all of our things together, the past 2 days. The biggest bummer is that we thought we were going to be pretty lucky because when we leave here tomorrow, we're going to Jamie's mom's house, which is nowhere near Sydney. We got locked down because we're about 2 hours or an hour and a half south of Sydney. So that is why we got locked down. So I was like, you know what? This is okay. It's only for 2 weeks. We can just go to Jamie's mom's house and live freely and then explore around there. But we found out that if we are in this area, and when then we move to a regional area, that we have to not self-isolate, we have to follow the same public health orders as if we were down here. So that means that Jamie and I are basically bound to the house, or if we go out exercising, until we leave, which is so sad. So lots of updates and lots of things have happened. So So I'm kind of bouncing back a little bit. I will have to say that I got my second dose of my Pfizer vaccine yesterday, and I thought everything was all good. You know, I came home last night and I felt a little bit like really tired, but that's about it. And I woke up this morning, felt fine. Jamie and I have just put together a lot of our stuff, and then it hit me. It hit me. I had full-on chills and body aches and all that fun stuff. And the Panadol that I just took has kicked in. And thank God, because it was just, I was not feeling well. I have like, no, I do not have time for this. So yeah, it's kind of nuts at the moment. Right now I am working on some last minute things to do for my work. They reached out to me, which is fine, to just do some things before I leave. But it is a little bit crazy at the moment because I am trying to move and then I have feel like this and then I'm still trying to do some work. But yeah, I'll show you kind of the state of our house at the moment. So right now, like, look at this pile. Look at this massive pile. Right now, we are planning to take from this tall guitar case here over to here. That is kind of like our Canada, what we're taking to Canada, except Dory. Dory, you're not in there. But we're planning to take this back. And clearly, this is just kind of chucked over there at the moment. We're going to be doing a final pack at Jamie's mom's and hopefully getting rid of some other things. Dory is so sad at the moment because we have sold everything for her to lay on. Usually she loves laying on like our table that's usually right here. We just sold our TV stand. And right now I'm literally laying in my bed in the middle of the lounge room. And we're selling our bed tonight. And other than that, this is all we have left, which is crazy. So we're heading up to Jamie's mom's in the morning. And I'm really hoping that I feel better before that. So yeah, that's kind of concludes this episode of the vlog. And the next episode is all going to be about us transitioning our life here, plopping it down to Jamie's mom's house for a little bit, and then moving. We move to Canada in 15 days. I don't know. My life right now.